chef from outdoors in the localities. Now, as you know, this is a front flail mower from Peruzzo that fits very well onto the Kubota at the front hitch. And I'm now using it as a flail mower, but Peruzzo also offers the opportunity to add these blades to the flail mower and then you turn it into a verticutter. So let's now add these blades to the flails and turn this flail mower into a verticutter as well.
The flail mower is mounted at the pallet fork implement in order to lift it so the blades can be mounted underneath.
So purely for safety, I also put in this old workmate. So whenever the hydraulics lets me down, I'm sure this old workmate will save me. There are 88 pieces in here. I didn't count them underneath, so I hope it's enough. We'll see. And it's great weather, by the way, so I will do it in the outdoors. Because, yeah, with this weather, you're not going to do it inside, of course. And here you have a look from the bottom side. So these are the flails. They're connected with a 17mm bolt. So I have to release the bolt and then put the blade in between. So the flails of this flail mower have this typical Y type of shape. And what I do is I take out one of the flails, put in the blade and put it back. So then you get still the Y shape, but in the middle you have the scarifying blade, which is then cutting into the ground. And it's a vertical cut, and that's why it's a verticutter. So all the blades are now mounted. In total there are 4 rows of 11 blades. So all 44 blades are now mounted. When you lie underneath doing the things, well, a lot of dirt drops onto you and that doesn't make you prettier, but it's been done. Peruzzo also warns that in the case that you have scarifying flail fittings, which I now have, I need to remove this angle bar because those will be hit with the blades. So now we're looking from the bottom side to see here the angle bar, and indeed the blades will hit the angle bar, so that needs to be removed. So this is the angle bar that has been taken out, so the scarifying blades can now run freely without hitting it. So it's now a real verticutter at the front. I'm very curious what the result will be. I didn't change the height of the mower because I really don't know whether it's going to be too high or too low or just good enough. Only one way to find out, and that's to try it. So that's what we're going to do right now. So I'm quite curious, to be honest, what the result will be. We'll see.
With the current height setting of the mower, the verticutting effect is very small. Therefore, the height setting of the front wheels is changed to the lowest setting. This lower height setting gives a clear improvement of the verticutting process.
So it seems to work very well. I think the verticut process goes very good. You see there's a lot of material coming off. It's even a fun process to do. So with the verticutter at the front side, mowing around with your Kubota is even nice. Very satisfying work. But what will be a little bit less nice, I expect, is to clean it all up. So what I will now first do So before I do now all the field, because that's a lot, I first want to clean this up a little bit to see how much comes off and how easy it is to clean. And I don't have a special system for cleaning, so that will be a little bit less nice job. So let's first do that. So you see there's quite some material taken off. I will collect it and then remove it. And it's clear that I need to do that in parts because I cannot do it all at once, because I have to do it by hand. It's also still a nice job, but I prefer riding the Kubota, to be honest. So the vertical thing goes fine, but I want to have it a little bit more deeper than I currently have. The front side is already at the lowest position, but I will also here lower this one. So here you see the difference between the two settings. This one is with the deeper setting, this one is with the more shallow setting. The blades are now really cutting into the sole surface, so it's really a vertical cut. It's also of course why it's called vertical cutting. But I think it's more effective in this setting, so I will leave it with the new setting and do the rest. So I demonstrated to create a verticutter or scarifier from a flail mower. I think it does a very good job. Still need a lot of cleaning up to do, but that's a part of the job, of course. But it works very well, and it's even a fun thing to do, verticutting with a flail mower. With the Kubota, of course. So, I hope you enjoyed the video. Still some work for me to do. Thanks for watching, and I see you next time.